English First Additional Language Class. This is, of course, the grade 11 class. Today we're doing summary writing. And as you know, I'm your presenter, Ayanda Shabalala. You can always contact me on the booksitterza@gmail.com. So I've got two very exciting announcements, important and exciting. I'm just going to say hi to you guys first. First of all, I'd like to say hi to Kobe, and we appreciate Kobe so much for making sure that this is possible for us. Hi, Boitumelo. Hi, Deshan. Hi, Eclipse. Hi, Kwanda. Hi, Mbali. Hi, Ntombi. Hi, Priyanka. And hi, Rook. And hi, Sbahle. Okay, so there's 11 of you guys. Okay, not 11. Nine of you guys today. Okay, great. So yesterday we were supposed to do summary writing, but I think we spent a lot of time on that comprehension text that we actually did not get to dwell on summary writing. So just what it is exactly and the importance of summary writing, right? Okay, so the objectives of this lesson is to help you guys determine essential ideas and consolidate important details that support them. Okay, so let me tell you something. Summary writing is so important, guys, because when you get to varsity, right? So I did humanities in my undergrad. I did politics and international relations at WITS. And if you do humanities, or I mean, I was at business school last year as well, and I still did writing. So when you're in varsity, you look at specific texts, right? You can use a whole book and reference that whole book, but only use two lines out of that whole book. You write? So you can summarize basically in one paragraph of your thesis or of the essay you are handing in to your lecturer. A book that is 600 pages. So summary writing is so important. It also just, you know, teaches you to read in such a way that by the time you're supposed to even write the assignment, you've summarized the main points because you understand the central idea and you are able to consolidate that. Is that clear? Okay, and the other thing is it enables you guys to focus on keywords and phrases of an assigned text that are worth noting and remembering. So if a text is about, let's say, ice cream, right? There will be, let's say it's a 200-word text. There will be other things that have very little to do with ice cream, but the central idea, the central idea and the focus of the text, you will get to use the most when you're summarizing, because even when you're asked to summarize, you're told what to focus on, right? And then the other thing is it teaches you guys to take a large selection of text and reduce it to the main points for more concise understanding. So what I was saying to you guys about varsity and how you'll literally use a whole 600-word book or research or journal article, right? That is written by an academic. And you'll need to summarize that. You will need to summarize that to the main points for concise understanding and to just, you know, put your point across, you know, using Karl Marx's thinking, I'm putting this point across, basically. So yeah, I hope that makes sense to you guys and you guys understand the importance of this. Okay, see, there's more people in class, which is great. We've got Lihle, we've got Jessica. Who else? Okay. Jessica, Lihle, Daisy, okay. I haven't said your name. I think Sbahle was here. Sbahle, you were here. If I haven't said your name, please say hi. If you're new to the class, you've never been to my class before, I hope you guys are going to be staying because we actually have quite a lot of fun in this class. Okay. So guys, please remind me about the two announcements because I had actually forgotten. So I'll give you guys the announcements at the end of the lesson. Yes, towards the end. So if someone could just remind me that when we're like almost done with the lesson, because I do have quite a few things on my mind right now. Okay, so summary rules, right? What I wrote there was omit. So by that, I mean that in summaries, what you're doing is just omitting. You're omitting information that is not as important as the central idea, right? So first step, what are the main ideas? What am I summarizing exactly? What is this text about, right? And then the second thing would be, what are the crucial details necessary for supporting the ideas, right? So that you will find in the text as well. And then you might be jotting down your summary by now. So usually I know with grade 11, they give you guys either 70 words or 90 words. I don't know how many words you guys used to get in grade 10. Maybe you guys can tell me in the group chat because I haven't spoken to you guys as well today. They usually want between 70. Yes, Priyanka, I see your hand is raised. Let us see. Sorry about that. Yes, Priyanka. Hi.
Sorry, ma'am. Hi, ma'am. The group chat is disabled.
Okay. Mbali's hand is also raised. What's happening? Hi, Bali.
Hi, Bev. How are you?
Okay. I cannot hear you guys. Oh, I know what's happening. My volume is muted. I'm so sorry, you guys. Okay. Okay, now I can hear you guys. Okay, I'm so sorry about that. Kobe, thank you so much for that. Our host has saved us once again. So I thought something was wrong, but my laptop was actually on mute. So that's why I couldn't hear you guys. So I saw Mbali had her hand up. I'm gonna unmute you just to hear what you had to say. Hi, Mbali.
Hi, ma'am.
How are you?
Good, thanks. How are you, ma'am?
I'm good, thanks.
No, I wanted to say the same thing as Priyanka.
Okay, I'm not hearing that properly.
I was saying the same thing as Priyanka. Your chat is disabled.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much, Bali and Priyanka. Okay, so I think I'm going to try and find you again and mute. Okay, so it's muted already. Hi, Priyanka.
Oh, sorry, that was a mistake.
Okay, all right, no problem. Okay, cool. Okay, so then you might be jotting down already, right? You might be jotting down the crucial details necessary for supporting the ideas. And you guys need more or less 70 to 90 words. And then while jotting down, you'll realize that, oh, I actually have more than the word limit, right? And then you will start filtering out information that is irrelevant or unnecessary, right? But you can only do that after picking all information with the main idea. So does that make sense to you guys? Okay. I didn't want to discuss many things because I realized that We spend a lot of time discussing and little time actually doing the work. Okay, so this is a summary activity that I want us to do in class, but also just to exercise your reading abilities and you know, just to hear you guys, because I really enjoy doing that. I think we should go over this passage. Do I have any volunteers for the reading? And it's a very short passage. So if I can have someone who will read paragraph 1, 2, 3, and then another person who will do 1, 2, and 3. Okay, sorry, that moved. So paragraph 1, 2, 3, and then paragraph 1, 2, 3. Okay, wait, 3 each, right? So there's 6 paragraphs. It's actually 7. Okay, so someone will do 4 because the ones at the top are very short. And then another person will do 3 because those are longer. So do I have any volunteers, guys? Guys, this is a very short text. Very short text. And I know you guys can do it. And the words are quite easy. Anyone wants to read for us? Okay, cool. I'll read it. Okay, so Ndombi is reading for us. Perfect. Let me just go to Ndombi. Hi, Ndombi.
Hi, ma'am.
How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
I'm good, thanks. Thank you for offering.
Okay.
Hit it, maestro.
Can I start?
Yes, please.
Okay. How to create a positive attitude. A negative attitude can prevent you from fully enjoying yourself, your life. One of the best things you can offer anyone is your positive attitude. Sometimes one single event can ruin any entire day, which is awareness.
Calm down. Do it again. Hey, Doms, I think you're reading too fast. So if you just calm down and start reading again. Did we lose Ndombi? Hello? Okay, it seems like we lost Ndombi a bit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue. Anyone else wants to continue? Please raise your hand like Ndombi did, or just tell me that you want to read on the group. Everyone deserves a chance. And probably by the end of this lockdown, everyone would have read in the class. So I'm actually going to start giving you guys assignments. That's one of the announcements, but I'm actually going to give you guys incentives for these assignments, right? Okay. So let me just start reading. If Ndombi doesn't come back, if Ndombi comes back, then she'll take over. Okay, so how to create a positive attitude. Eclipse raised their hand. Love to see it. Okay. Hello.
Hi, everyone.
How are you, Hello. Eclipse?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good, thanks.
Okay, let me continue.
Okay, please do. Something happened to my screen. Okay, please do. Please start from the top.
A negative attitude can prevent you from fully enjoying your life. One of the best things you can offer anyone is your positive attitude. Sometimes one single event can ruin an entire day. With this awareness that your mind tends to cling to the negative, you can intentionally focus on the good parts of your day. Keep a gratitude journey. Is it journal?
Mm.
Oh, it's journal.
Yes.
Learn to accept rejection. Click every broken heart and failed job interview as practice. Because no one goes through life without being rejected. The words that you use have power. If you describe your life as boring, that is how you will.
That's how you get. Are you done?
Yes, I'm done.
Thank you so much.
I'm done.
Thank you so much, Eclipse. That was beautifully read. I kind of got distracted while you were reading, but thank you so much for that. Priyanka has also raised her hand. And I take it you would like to continue from where Eclipse stopped. You guys are doing so amazing. I love how you guys are actually gaining confidence. You guys are actually engaging more. I really appreciate the efforts, guys. Okay.
My turn now.
Priyanka. Hi, Priyanka.
Hi. I'm going to try because I'm dyslexic. So if I get words wrong, I'm sorry.
No problem. No problem, darling.
Use positive words to describe your life. Do you ever notice how many times you say, I have to do something? I have to go to work. Now replace the word have with get. I get to go to work. Your attitude will now change from needing to fulfill obligations,
yes,
to gain grateful.
Yes.
Okay.
Do you want to continue?
I'm fine.
You're actually doing very well.
Okay, I'll carry on. It is hard to have hope and stay positive when hate and violence are all over the media. Notice the
righteous
in times of tragedy.
Yes.
Am I right? Begin. Positive does not mean that you have to be
oblivious
to problems. If you are going to point out problems, have solutions too. Thank you.
You can continue.
Oh!
Two more.
Set a goal each day to make someone else smile. Think about something else. Think about someone else's happiness, yes. And you will realize the impact your attitude has on that person.
Thank you so much, Priyanka.
It's a pleasure, guys, ma'am.
I know we're supposed to dive right back into the work right now, but I just wanted to say that I am so proud of you guys. I'm so proud of Priyanka, I'm so proud of Ndombi, and I'm proud of Eclipse as well as Gwanda, like everyone who's tried, and I know that more of you are going to try. I am extremely impressed by Priyanka today, because I think it's a big thing and it's a very courageous thing to actually, you know, open up to the class and be like, hey guys, I'm actually dyslexic, but I'm going to try this out. I think there is nothing that beats that, that literally made my day today. My heart is so warm. Like, wow, guys, I know I'm making a big thing out of this, but I am really, 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 really touched. Like, you guys don't know how much this actually means to me. The fact that I actually get to, you know, touch your lives, and you guys get to touch mine, and you guys are actually willing to try in this space, and you guys are starting to feel like this is a safe space. So this is very important to me, and this is the kind of relationship I want us to have. You guys need to feel safe around your peers, and you guys need to feel safe around me. So I'm extremely, extremely proud of you guys. If I could, I'd give you all chocolates. Okay. But for the sake of the lesson, let's get back to this. So I need you guys to write this in point form of 7 points. And the word count has to be no more than 70. Your points should be done with the rules provided in mind. So the rules that I gave you guys, and those rules were: sift out all the important information, and then... write that out, and then sift out what is correct, right? So I'm gonna give you guys see what time is it, 25 past 11. I will give you guys 10 minutes to do this, so it'll be 10 minutes on this activity, and 10 minutes on the next. I'm just trying to figure out if you guys are actually able to send me files, because I know I can send you guys files, but I'm not sure if you guys are actually able to send me files. Let's see if to send you guys something just now, you'd be able to receive it. I'm just trying to find, you know, simplest thing to send. Okay.
Ma'am, I can confirm that they can send you files via the chat.
Oh, so they can send files. Thank you so much. Okay, so I'm guessing you guys will send that to me through the chat. If you cannot do that, then you can write the answers, the 7 points on your phone. It's just 7 points, so that should be 7 sentences. That shouldn't be difficult on your phone. I'm sure you guys text your friends and your boyfriends and your girlfriends long paragraphs. So this shouldn't be an issue, right? Okay, I'll just be counting down on the time, and I'll be doing the activity as well. 5 minutes to go, guys. Guys, I'm on my last point. This was quite a very simple one. Hope everyone is on the same track. Now I'm counting my words. Okay, so in an exam, you won't necessarily have time to count your words, but if you are well within 7 points and it's one sentence per point, you're probably around 70 words. But I'm just counting my words right now to see if I am more or less around 70. You won't be marked down if you write 68 words, and you won't be marked down if you write 72 words. But if you do write 80 words, you could be marked down. And if you write 60 words instead of 70, most likely. So, yeah. Okay, so I've got 43 words. That means there is some missing information that I considered to be irrelevant. But according to the question, I need 70 words because what sums up the conversation, the text more, is 70 words in comparison to 43. So I am going to look at where I can add certain points that I thought were not important to make it around 70 words. 9:51. Okay, guys, it looks like we're way above time. Does anyone want to share their summary right now with us? Does anyone want to share their summary? Okay, or would you guys just prefer that I read mine out? Okay, Lerardo would like to share hers. Thank you so much, Kobe. So that is an instruction from our host on how to upload a file onto the group chat so we can all view it. I see Lerardo's hand is, oh, okay, sorry. Hi, Lerardo.
Hi, Mom, how are you?
Good, thanks, how are you?
Good, okay, here is my summary.
Okay, we're all listening attentively.
On my first point, I indicated that one needs to live their life with less negative attitudes in order for them to be happy.
Okay.
And on the second point, I said, focus on the good things instead of the bad.
Okay.
And on the third, I said, do not be saddened by rejection. And on the fourth, I said, practice living with gratitude, and that will evoke a feeling of positivity.
Oh, that's a good one.
Thank you. And on the fifth one, I said, be a problem solver instead of one who, be a problem solver instead of one who always comes up with them.
And,
and on the sixth one, I said, spread the love and make other people happy. And on the seventh one, I'm not really sure. So I'll just end on the sixth and others might continue.
Okay, how many, do you know how many words that was?
No, one, two.
Okay, but you have an idea. Lerato's summary is actually good. Yes, Eclipse, I do agree with you. Does anyone else want to read their summary? Thank you so much, Lerato. That was so amazing.
Thank you.
I see that you are an emotional writer, which is quite a good thing. It makes you a persuasive person. Okay, so does anyone else want to read their summary? Okay, cool. I will read mine. So the first point I had was a positive attitude is better than a negative one. The second point was focus on the good parts of your day and keep a gratitude journal. Number three, learn to accept and learn things. Oh, learn to accept and learn from rejection as this is practice. Number four, use positive words at all time. Number five, show more gratitude. Number six, create solutions to problems. And number seven, let your attitude have an impact on others. Okay, so I think this was quite a fun exercise. Does everyone else agree? Did everyone else have points that are leaning towards the points that Lerato and I gave? Is there anything that you guys would like to say? Okay, we've got 5 minutes remaining. Okay, cool. So this was supposed to be a summary that was supposed to be done in pairs. Guys, we actually need to do something about time management in this class. And it's not a you thing, it's actually a me thing. I don't know if I just prepare too much work and then we run out of time, or we spend a lot of time talking about other things, but I thoroughly enjoy the class, so I wouldn't change anything about the things we actually do talk about, okay? So this is supposed to be class exercise, but you guys might just have to do it at home, because we will definitely run out of time. We are 4 minutes away from the lesson ending, and I know that it will not take you guys 4 minutes to write a 90-word paragraph with 7 to 8 sentences. So what I can do is we'll either do it tomorrow in class, but I did want to do poetry tomorrow because I was looking at some poetry that I did in high school, and it looks like you guys are still doing poetry like that. So I was quite excited about that, but you guys will definitely let me know. Oh, Ntombi just reminded me about the announcements. Thank you so much, Ntombi. Okay, so I'll just decide if I'm emailing you this or we do it tomorrow. You guys can share your thoughts in the group chat about what you guys think should happen with this work. Okay, so firstly, I'd like to say thank you guys for your cooperation. And remember that the end of the class is always suggestion, query, and appreciation time. Guys, Eklos finally has an email. I'm very excited. Please email me. Can I please be the first person you email? And I will definitely... Okay, I'm going to carry on taking more emails. Okay, more email addresses. Eclipse, do you mind emailing me and I can be the first person to receive an email from your address? Okay, we've also got Lerato's email. Sorry, guys. We've also got Lerato's email, which is great. Okay, we also have Lihle's. I hope I'm saying it right. Is it Lihle? Yes, it's Lihle. Okay, guys, so... The first announcement, what time is it? The first announcement is that I am going to be your Zulu grade 11 instructor, which is great because I know a lot of you guys do Zulu. So from tomorrow at 8 a.m., I'm going to be doing Zulu as well. This does not mean that I won't be doing English. I'll continue doing English, but I just have Zulu as well now. So I'd really love to see you guys there. If you're doing grade 11 Zulu, please join my Zulu class. It's early because I was given that slot. I wanted to do 12 so that we can be in a class where we have English at 11 and then we do Zulu at 12. But it seems some of you have physics at 12. So I'll be doing Zulu at 8 a.m. The other announcement is that I want us to play a Kahoot game on Friday. And I want you guys to really, really, really participate. I will be buying you guys data, whoever wins the game. So whoever has the most scores on our Kahoot game on Friday, I will be buying you data. And if we do not play the Kahoot game on Friday, whenever we do play it, we'll always have prizes. So I will Uber Eats you, or I will buy you data or anything like that. So yeah, hope you guys will be enjoying our games, and I hope you guys will be looking forward to it. Not a lot of data. You guys don't need a lot of data, do you? Okay, guys, I'm gonna have to go just now. I've had a really great lesson today. See you guys tomorrow when we finish the summary thing, and we'll probably do one poem. I see Priyanka's hand is up. We really have to go now. Let me hear. Yes, Priyanka.
Hi, ma'am. What's Kahoot game about? What is the Kahoot game about?
On the game, so it's okay. Tomorrow I will explain Kahoot to you guys. It's a very easy app. It's not even an app. You just can play it online. So I will explain it to you guys on Friday. I'll give you a link and we'll play it. And then we'll play it to win. We'll first play it as like, you know, to teach those that can't play it. And then we'll play it to win. How's that? So I'll explain it tomorrow and I have to go now. Bye, guys. Have a good day. It's always great teaching you, hearing you, socializing with you. You guys are amazing. I have no doubt that you guys are going to be awesome varsity students. Bye, guys. See you tomorrow. And please come to my Zulu class.